treatment immediately when they want it, and that's the most important time to be able to get treatment to people. And if we aren't able to come up with those funds, you know, it's a problem. In terms of, I mean, we could certainly put aside some money for, you know, liability, but that decision hasn't been made yet. I just kind of left that part blank because I figured it would go through the committee process, and those committees would make those decisions.
I want to read a question that we got from Dave, who says, out of the gate, this is preposterous. Two plants grown outdoors will yield from 2 to 4 ounces or more each. As soon as it is harvested, you will be in violation of the law. Even a casual user will use up to 1 ounce in a month or two. Then it takes another year to produce a crop. It needs to be available in a retail dispensary or be allowed to be grown in a realistic quantity for personal use. Representative Conquest, so Dave's already worried about, you know, being in violation of the law just by having the legally allowed two mature plants. I asked you about how you got to those numbers, but how do you figure that that would work?
So, first of all, that's in the law, the 1 ounce limit is not, you can have the 1 ounce in possession, but the amount that comes from your plant, as long as you keep it in your house, essentially where it was grown, then you can have whatever came off of the plant, and you just can't take more than an ounce of it out of the house with you.
Basically, if you have it in your pocket, it needs to be less than an ounce.
Exactly. You know, we've heard testimony from folks at the Agency of Agriculture who taught us all, I think, a lot, or I said taught me anyway, a lot about how marijuana is grown. You know, it seems to vary quite a bit. The amounts that are produced vary widely depending on whether it's grown indoors or outdoors, whether you're very good at growing marijuana. And so it's impossible to really say that a plant will produce X amount. So for that reason, we decided that we wanted to put in a number of plants that would provide any person who wants it for personal use enough to supply themselves over the course of a year. And apparently there's various different ways of either letting it grow to full maturity or having offshoots of a single mature plant and using those. But in any case, we try to find a level that provided enough for most people to be able to supply themselves with marijuana for their use over the year, so that they could do that if they chose to.
Other comments coming in from listeners. Bob says, simple, alcohol is legal, weed should be legal. Why is this an issue? Michael in St. Johnsbury calls for a different approach altogether. He says, the amount of time spent on this subject has been absurd. I implore all of you that